Oh my gosh. I don't understand what I'm looking at. It's only been a week and the candy's gone and there's what? Well, believe it or not, it's a cold winter day, but it's not that cold. It's warming up, even though it's about the 5th or 6th of December by the time I publish this. Warm enough for me to work some bees today. So what I want to do is bait the bees over here to this feeder with some sugar water, some honeybee healthy smell. And once I get more bees over here, I can work my hives because my bees are going to be a little bit busy out there working this sugar water here. And you can also see some solar panels in the background. I've mentioned those before. I'm going to give you an update on how that's going. Got a lot to do. Let's get started. Wow, I stepped away for a minute and all the bees showed up. I'm going to mix some protein powder, some sugar, some hot water, mix it up in my Ninja blender. And that way I can get a better mix on my feeding solution. But as you can see, the bees are already getting into my pollen jar. Not only are they getting into it, you know, they're collecting the pollen on their back legs, but as you can see, like on the table, they're kind of fluffing it up as they're getting it all over their bodies. Look at that. And as a result, they're getting this pollen kind of scattered around, but that's how much bees love dry pollen. Even in the winter, if you have a day or two where you can throw some dry pollen out when it's warm like this and bees are flying, it can really help bees a lot. But anyway, let's go ahead and mix this solution up. So what I'm going to do first is just take my jar here and I'm going to pour my water in it first. And I have 12 ounces of water. And it's not bad. It's not really boiling or anything, but it's just hot out of my tap. I'm also going to take 12 ounces of sugar and I hope it all fits in there. If it doesn't, I'll just stop. All right, it did. And now I'm going to add the protein powder here, minus the bees. I'm going to just have to get these bees out of there. I can see they're falling in. That one's going to walk out eventually. There we go. All right, so let's add this protein powder. Try to keep all the bees from getting chomped up in the mix. Wow. Okay, it's about 59, almost 60 degrees here. I'm kind of waiting for it to turn warmer to get into the hives. I promised you guys I would do an inspection, but before I do my inspection, what I want to do is get my bees over to a feeder, and that way I have bees doing something as I do my inspections. All right, so now we're going to put it on here and see if we can blend this mix together, see what happens. I've never tried this before, but somebody recommended it on a YouTube comment. So let's see what happens. Let's see, pulse. Oh. Blend. What's high speed? Wow, I'm actually going to add this amount to more sugar water. So it's not, this whole solution here is not the final solution. I'm just mixing the powder up in a liquid solution so I can add it to more water. So it will be diluted a lot from this mixture here. My dad was an electrician, and he always taught me on these motors like this, never to run them a long time. They'll overheat. I don't know if that's true anymore, but I just can't help but run a motor like this only a little while, just a few seconds at a time. And the reason I'm trying this, by the way, is because some of you have shared that some of the protein powder doesn't really mix up well in the sugar jars when you feed them from a top feeder, and it kind of clogs up some of the holes maybe in those top jars. And I just thought maybe I could blend it better like that. I have no idea if it's going to help, but worth a try. All right, well, let's call that good for now. Wow. Well, since it's really a nice day today, bees are everywhere. You have to kind of be cognitive of what you pick up because there's probably a bee sitting on it. So this is the solution I mixed up a few minutes ago. And we're gonna add a little bit of this protein liquid to this. Not a lot. I'm gonna save this for later. It's just enough to give it a little protein mix in that sugar water. And then I'm gonna put this in this feeder here. It's right close to the house. Bees are only gonna be flying for a few days, maybe 2 or 3 days like this. And then they're not gonna fly anymore because the weather's gonna turn cold. So I'm gonna put a little bit of this here next to the house. I would never do this in the summertime, get bees drawn to my house like this. But now I need to put some floating material in here so bees don't drown. And I just grab whatever is close to me, which is tree bark that's fallen off some trees in my front yard here. I really don't have a front yard. I live out in the country, but we would call it our front yard. This would give bees a chance to kind of climb out of here. Bees are not good swimmers, but they are good at climbing onto something and flying out. And that'll give them something to stand on too. It will take them a little bit here to find this and start using it. This is just a way to get more bees doing something on a nice warm day because there's nothing out there for them to forage on today. You know, I sent out a little community question yesterday on YouTube, and I asked you, what do you want me to show you in these hives? And you can do that on YouTube. It's pretty cool, isn't it? A lot of you responded. You told me what you wanted me to show you. I think only subscribers are able to see those kind of community comments that I'm leaving and asking you questions and asking you to give me input on what you want me to do in my videos. So if you're not a subscriber, you're gonna miss out on that and you're not gonna have any input. So please subscribe so you can be a part of a huge beekeeping community that we have here on our channel, and that way you can tell me. But a lot of you said you wanted me to look at two hives and kind of compare them. You wanted me to show some resources, maybe find the queen, see what's going on in there. Should you open up a hive now that in Illinois, for all intents and purposes, we're done with bees and we're going into winter, even though winter is not for another, what, 10 or 15 days. It has been cold. It's been 20 degrees or colder. And so bees really are tucked away for winter. Should you open up your hives once you have them kind of in bed for winter? Absolutely not. I don't think you should. You should not break the propolis seal. You should not risk killing your queen during an inspection. You should leave them alone. Put a winter be kind on them like we did last week and wrap them up if you need to. But don't open your hives up on a warm winter day because I'm worried that you'll kill your queen and there's no replacing her. Even when spring comes, all the queens are really taken up in the spring for package bees. And so you're not gonna get a queen until May or June when your hive dies. So I would not recommend you do this. I'm doing it because I have a lot of hives and, you know, it's for experimentation purposes and for making a video and for entertainment. So don't do what I'm doing. But now that I'm doing it, you might as well take a look with me and see what's going on. Yeah, there's a lot of bees on this empty winter be kind with the protein powder on it. That's pretty cool. Wow. Well, I thought I'd just go ahead and get started with our bee inspection, and I'm gonna light my smoker, put my bee suit on. Gosh, it's amazing that it's already December the 3rd, and nice warm day today. It's pushing 60 degrees. We have a high today of 61. And that's why I decided to come out and work my bees. Again, I don't want you to do that. I don't think you should. It needs to be a little bit warmer than this. But I've got a building there that's blocking the western wind, so it's not going to be too bad. We don't want to hold our brood frames out too long, especially the capped over pupae. But we'll have fun doing that. Look at this. This is a Christmas coffee cup that Sherry bought me. and we're getting close to Christmas, and it's exciting, isn't it? Yeah, I love Christmas. As a kid, Christmas was always a special time for me growing up. I've got a brother and a sister, so Christmas was exciting. Our parents really made it fun. They had a lot of Christmas spirit. Both my parents have passed on. I really miss them. My dad is my hero. He taught me so much about life. He taught me everything. He taught me how to deal with people. He taught me how to fight. He taught me how to take care of myself. Taught me how to shoot a gun, how to hunt, all that stuff. How to fish, how to pour concrete. He taught me how to go to church. He taught me how to treat a woman. He taught me how you should treat your wife. He taught me how to wire a house. Taught me how to fix cars. He taught me how to take things apart and put them back together again. Hang on. Yeah, I shouldn't have answered that as spam. What I'm most disappointed about my parents dying and not being here at this moment is that they never got to see me start a bee business. And that's who I am now. I'm not the same person that I was when I was, well, 10 years ago or 20 years ago. I feel like I don't even know that guy. And I'm a whole different person. And if you try to say, oh, I knew David back in when he was 20 or 30 or 40 or 50, you didn't really know me. You knew who I was then, but you really can't say you know who he is now. Because I am really a different guy for the better. I'm happy about that. I wish my parents could see that. I'm disappointed that I have to go through another Christmas without celebrating with my parents. And but on the other hand, I am a parent. I have 6 children. And I am very enthusiastic about Christmas with my children. Now, all my children are grown. Most of you know that. My youngest son is still at home, and he's 14. We have a great time with our family. We really do. Tomorrow night, we're going over to Sleepy Creek. It's a winery that's about a mile that way. And we're going to watch a night of comedy there with some of my family, some of my children. That'd be fun. Stuff like that. So even though you go through transitions where you have to say, I miss somebody. Maybe some of you miss your husband that passed away, or your wife, or a child. And it's hard to go through Christmas with somebody that you love having passed away. I know this sounds like I'm not very compassionate, but you do have to move on. They would want you to have a good time. My parents would not want me to be depressed that they're gone. They want me to enjoy Christmas with my family. And my gosh, my dad would be the first person to say, David, don't think about us. You enjoy your family. Go out there and have a good time at Christmas. I don't want you to be sad. That's a waste of time. And so anyway, Christmas is about family. And yeah, it does bring back some memories that we wish we could be nostalgic about and go back in time and reflect on. That's all good and healthy, but we got to move on and move forward and get things done and set a new tradition with our current family and just have a good time with it. Oh, by the way, have you ever heard of bulletproof coffee? I'm drinking bulletproof coffee today. And if you don't know what bulletproof coffee is, I'll make a video about that, okay? I'll try to work that in the next video after this one. I can't do it today. I'm on a tight schedule. but bulletproof coffee is essentially coffee that I make in a French press, and then you add butter to it, and then you add MCT oil. MCT oil is what's the best way to describe it? Medium chain triglycerides. It's sort of like almost, it's part of coconut oil, I guess. Anyway, it's supposed to be a very energy-inducing drink that you drink. Some of my friends got me started on bulletproof coffee, and I don't know if it's just all kind of psychological. When you drink it, you feel like you're bulletproof. You know, you feel like you got a lot of energy. One of my friends claims it's helping him lose weight and have a lot of energy. And anyway, it's kind of cool. That's what I'm drinking today, bulletproof coffee. And only bulletproof coffee can allow you to sit next to stinging insects and not be stung. And that's not true. Well, anyway, I'm going to get my smoker and my bee suit on so that we can jump in these hives today. But let me take a sip of this energy drink, coffee, make sure no bees are sitting in there, and we'll get started. My dad always told a funny story about Christmas. I'm going to put that in there without burning my fingers and putting the fire out. Whew. And my dad said that he was so poor growing up in Arkansas that one Christmas he got an orange, a firecracker, and a plastic fake gun. And he said he ate the orange, he put that firecracker down the barrel of that fake plastic gun and blew that gun up, and in less than a minute, Christmas was over. Wow, that is one heck of a fire right there. That's gonna work. Let's get working. Let's go ahead and suit up and get going. One of the things I forgot to do is put my grate in there, and I'm not gonna change it now. I think it'll burn fine without it, but that should go in there. It fell out and I forgot to put it in there. All that in 1 week? I mean, I know there's a lot of bees in there, but I've never seen them eat. I mean, there's nothing even in a corner, and there's no sign of anything on the edges. I'm gonna have to review the video and make sure I put one on with candy. Winter bee kind going on with the opening toward the front. Wow, I totally shocked. I mean, it does look like a gigantic colony based on how many bees there are, but oh my gosh. I'm gonna have to keep feeding them. I mean, there's not even a sign of any sugar dustings anywhere. Wow. Let me see if I can smoke them and pull a frame out. Take a look. That's a lot of packed bees in there. Well, you know, it makes sense. There's just two deeps and I don't have a super on here, right? I guess that makes sense. That they're going to eat more if they don't have a lot of their own stored resources. All right, I'll give them that, I guess. I'm going to pull the center frame up and look for evidence of brood. So let's go with this frame here. Strategically begin to see if we can work that frame up. This hive has a lot of propolis, and that propolis is very hard in the winter time. All right. There we go. I'm going to put my thumb there to hold that frame down. Oh boy. Not coming up easily. I am encouraged that this frame appears to be a frame of honey, though. That would be nice. I mean, like, why did they eat my entire winter bee kind when they had a frame of honey, or a whole maybe deep full of honey right here? We'll see. Let's smoke them a little bit more. Wiggle it out so that it doesn't hurt any comb. Let's set it here to take a look. Yeah, that's just capped over honey. It looks really funky, but I can show you what it is by piercing it, and you'll just see honey run out. Well, they have a lot of food on board on this top deep. The next frame is all honey capped over too. This side is all capped over honey. So They just devoured my winter bee kind. But I'm afraid they might be deeper down in there because there's a lot of bees in that second deep. And they may just have honey in this stored deep. I kind of feel like there would have been brood in the center frame if there was brood in the top deep. So the cluster may still be, the brood area may still be down in that bottom deep. So let's look at one more before we make a real good decision. Wow, that propolis is tight. Here we go, lifting it up. Well, this is a little bit lighter in weight. No, it's not, it's heavy. No, that's all capped over honey. Wow, this is a whole frame of capped over honey. I am not gonna disturb this colony enough to go down to that second deep, I'm sorry. I mean, I just don't wanna tear it open that much in the winter time. But I will look at one more. And we are gonna have to put a winter bee kind on here, like an emergency winter bee kind, like emergency, because this colony is consuming a lot of food, which means they could really be making some brood in that bottom deep. There we go. I'm hoping to find a little brood, you know, like in the middle frame here, maybe down on the bottom of it. Let's see. That's a lot of bees, isn't it? A lot of bees. No, I'm afraid this colony is nothing but this first deep here on top is nothing but honey and nectar. Golly, look at that stored honey. All right, you know what? I'm going to just go ahead and put this back together. There's just packed bees down in that second deep, below this one anyway. So let's just put it back together and call it good. It would be too costly in bee health of this colony to actually tear it apart and go down one more this time of the year. I just don't want to do that. All right, so let's take the empty winter bee kind off. And let's give them a new one. Now, let's verify that one's filled. And we'll put it on there. I think today is December the 2nd. So we'll make a note of that. In fact, I think I'll write it. Oh, get out of there, stink bug. I think I'll scratch in December 2, 2021. All right, now we'll know. We'll come back in 1 week, which will be December the 9th, and we'll see what they've done. Wow. Okay, so here we go. This is the hive that we put a winter bee kind on in the last video. Well, I actually put them on all of them down here at this area, but you get the idea anyway. Nice. You can see that they've eaten right above the cluster. They're staying right there eating away that candy. See what else is going on in here. Let's just start working them. You know, I like talking to you guys, by the way. Some of you are like, hey, don't do all this talking. Just go ahead and get to the point so that we can know what we're supposed to do in beekeeping. Well, I like making videos where I get a chance to talk. I'm a talker. You gotta let me talk. If the video's too long, oh, that's a green drone comb. Not pulled out from last spring or fall. Not pulled out from last summer. Just sitting there. This hive did not get big or do much other than sit here. I was just experimenting with a single deep to see what a single deep would do. Oh, there's a bee with some pollen on her leg. And a frame of honey, capped over honey. Let's set that out temporarily over here since the weather is really warming up nice now. Wow. And let's see what else is in here. Wow, this is a heavy frame of honey and nectar on both sides. Some orange pollen on the back of that leg. Where in the world that's coming from? Who knows? But what we're looking for in here is to see what is available as far as resources and brood and queen and all that. Again, it's not a good idea to ever inspect your hive once you put them down for winter. if you live in a northern climate, because you're breaking propolis seals and you run the risk of killing your queen. And if you kill your queen, it's over. There's no way to replace her. They can't raise another one. It's done. So it's risky to do this. Again, I'm doing it because I've got a lot of hives to play with, and I like to do it for entertainment value of YouTube videos and give you some ideas about beekeeping. I saw a beetle. This is an idea that some of you don't know, that beetles overwinter. Right there is a beetle. They overwinter with bees in the cluster, no matter how cold it gets. I think I got it. I think I drowned it in the honey. So coming out of spring, coming out of winter into spring, not unusual to have a beetle problem. There's a lot of this orange pollen on the legs of these bees. I mean, not a lot, but a lot for this time of the year. No brood. Look at that nectar stored. This colony actually has a lot of food. Now that is not brood. That's capped over honey. And there's some more of that orange pollen. So let's keep seeing what we might find if we keep looking. I'm just curious about the queen and brood over here. It seems like the cluster is in this area according to where they're eating that winter bee kind. While I was talking about my dad a minute ago, I remember one time he taught us how to skateboard. And we lived between, our driveways were between two houses. There's a lot of beetles in here. And he got us a skateboard, and he determined that he was going to show us how to ride that skateboard on that concrete driveway. See that brood right there? Let's look for the queen or eggs. And anyway, he proceeded to get on that skateboard, telling us how to do it. He didn't have elbow pads, a helmet. You know, back then, 1960-something. Shoot, nobody had protective anything. He put one foot on that skateboard, and the other foot, he gave it a big push, and he fell right on the top of his head and laid his head open on that concrete. And me and my sister, my brother, you know, shoot, we were probably 5, 6, 8 years old. Woo! He got my mom to drive him to the neighborhood doctor. Back then, they had neighborhood doctors. And the doctor shaved some of his hair off and sewed his head back together. Well, at that point, I don't think either me or my sister or my brother had any interest at all in skateboarding. We were like, all right, we're done doing that. No interest. We'll stick to the bicycle. That was in Memphis, Tennessee in the 60s. All right, let's see what's on this frame. I didn't look for the queen too heavy on that other frame. I should have. Since I saw brood, I'll go back. Be nice to see the queen in the winter time like this. Again, a lot of nectar. Now, would you say there's a queen in here? Probably, because we saw a capped over brood, right? So that means it's about at least 8-day old brood. Again, this is just another frame of not many bees and nectar. And some more orange pollen. I'm going to hold it up here, give it a good look over. Yeah, something like this is a little hard to negotiate, because you kind of don't know what you're looking for. The bees are clustered, they're break cluster to fly one day. Here's some nectar and bee bread on this frame. They have a lot of good nutritious food on these frames. This other side, let me show you this other side. Look at the bee bread in there and pollen, but mostly bee bread and nectar. Now I see eggs and beetles, but I see eggs on the base of these cells. I'm not sure if my camera is going to focus on it that well. I'm going to try to move it in and out a little bit. But I do see eggs laid. See that queen? See the bee there with orange pollen on her legs? Just a little bit off there, you'll see eggs down in there. Maybe you can't see them, it's too dark. But anyway, that's an indication that I do have a queen in here. And I'm looking for her, but she's probably underneath a pile of bees. And you can see how the bees are just hanging on the bottom of this frame here. And if the queen is in there, I'm not going to be able to see her. It's not like the middle of summer when they're kind of more spread out over the frames. These bees are just too clumped up on the bottom of these frames like this to actually see much. So I'm not very optimistic about my experiments with overwintering and single deeps. I just don't think this one is in very good shape, even if I keep feeding them. Not a lot of brood. All right, let's get into this hive. It's a hive that's been a star here on YouTube all summer long. As recently as just a week ago when we put the winter bee kinds on it. Now let's get this brick off and start looking into it. Ooh, this should be pretty easy to get off, I think. Yep. Have they done anything in 1 week with that winter bee kind? Let's get our smoker kind of ready here. Well, I got warm enough where the propolis grabbed it. I don't want to put too much smoke or I'll run them off. Yep, this is what happens sometimes when all the candy will drop down onto these frames. And when that happens, it doesn't bother me at all. I kind of like it actually. If it stays there onto the board, it's fine. But if it drops down onto these frames, the tops, they just continue to eat it and work it down through the hive, so it's not an issue at all either. So that's what happens sometimes with these winter bee kinds. So what we're going to do is just take this, there's a little hoverfly, I'll be darned, flew in there probably after I opened it. Somebody asked the question, can you tell if these are bees of winter physiology? And no, you just kind of have to assume that they are, but there's really no way to tell. I want to leave that candy on there. They're having a good time eating it. So what I'm going to do is just take this super off so that we can drop below it. I'm going to be careful to keep this super flat so the sugar remains on there as it is. Unfortunately, that's heavy. Almost too heavy to move. All right, very good. Now, let's go ahead and get in here and see what we got. Below that super, you can see the bees are dropping some of the candy down onto the cluster. And in some of my early experiments with winter bee kinds, I noticed that the bees love to kind of drop the candy down onto the winter cluster. That's what you see here, these little white specks are. Let me try to pull this frame up. It looks pretty freed up to be going straight up without damaging any comb. We look at it and we say, a lot of resources. There's some bee bread down on the cells there. Hard to see with all the bees on it. And on this frame, I don't see any eggs. I just see bees walking around a frame of honey capped over. Let's just set this out for a minute so it gives us a little more room to move around. Let's smoke these bees. There's a lot of bees in here for winter, isn't it? A strong winter colony. All right, move this over a little bit. Pull this out, see what, oh, it's light, which means it could have some brood on it. Well, I don't see any brood. Looking for the queen. A little bit of capped honey at the top, but not much going on here. Let's flip it over. I'm kind of looking for the queen, seeing if I can see her on these frames here, and seeing if I can get the sun down in the cells. I don't see anything unusual or unique about this frame. It seems like just a frame of bees. There's a lot of frames in there. Let's keep looking at another frame, frame by frame. There's a little bit of brood on this frame in the middle, right in through here, capped over brood. So let me see if there's any eggs. Oh yeah, so I see eggs and larvae right in here. I'm gonna try to bring that up to the camera here. So let's look for the queen on this frame. Since there she is. You see her? She got a white dot on her that's kind of rubbed off, it looks like. Look at my hive tool and show you. Here's our queen at the tip of my hive tool. Do you see her right there? Yeah. She's walking around, got a rubbed off white dot on her. So let's put her safely back over here, facing that way. And what we'll do is take this frame, so we don't want to kill her. We know she's on this side of the frame. So if we put this frame in like this and slide it over toward that frame instead of down, we know she's safely there and we won't hurt her. But I want to look at a couple more frames, see what's going on. All right, let's look at this frame here. Yeah, I'm not seeing a lot of brood at all. I saw a little bit on the frame that the queen was on, but this one has no brood on it at all either. Well, I'll take that back. There is some brood here. Right in the middle here. That's what you're going to find in the winter time. I always heard like a handful of brood. So there is a small amount of brood. They have to keep that warm in the center. So there's a lot of work that has to go into that. What is that? Maybe 300 bees if it emerged. So we might find on every frame in the brood nest area a section of brood about that big. You're not going to find a frame of brood here, a frame of brood there, a frame of brood here, because in the wintertime they can't keep that warm if they have to go to a tight cluster. So that's why we're seeing these small patches of brood probably in the brood nest area. And if you're thinking like I am already, there's no way I'm going to take this deep off and look at the bottom deep, because I just don't want to. The queen is there, we are seeing brood, we see lots of bees. We have a honey super on top of them, full of honey. We have the winter bee kind. See, there's a little bit of honey here at the corner. This, to me, looks like an empty frame that the bees are just hanging out on. Yep, there's nothing on this frame at all. Let's look on this side. Nope, not much at all. So they're being very conservative on what they're doing with keeping their hives very, very idled back for winter. All right, let's look at this frame. A nice frame of honey. It's heavy. It's got bee bread. So let's move that a little closer to where that queen is. Oh, let me do that now. The queen is on this frame, so I'm going to move this honey frame and put it right in between this frame right here. Wow, there's a lot of bees. Let's smoke them. I like seeing a lot of bees in the wintertime. like this. It's just really good to know. And there, I can look down into the second deep, and all I see is just wall-to-wall bees down below as well. So I did a good job raising a lot of bees of winter physiology. Dang, there's a lot of bees in there. All right, let's make enough space here to kind of bring it all together. Just a good frame of honey that we're going to put kind of more in the center of the hive here. Go gingerly so we don't kill bees or anything like that. Guide it down gently. And right before we land, we'll smoke the bees off of those ears so we don't smash any bees under the ears. I put a little bit too much burlap in here. I'm going to keep running it to keep it going. I've got so much burlap in here, it's almost smothering my smoker. Let me show you. Look at that. Wow. I jammed it full in there. It's like, and I don't have that grate on the bottom. I forgot to put that in there, but it's working. It's doing its job and it's making me plenty of smoke, but I got to keep an eye on it or else it might smother itself out. Okay, I can push that down. It's free of bees under there, and that's free of bees under there. All right, well, I've seen enough there. All right, I'm going to break my back and put this, what feels to be at least, oh my gosh. Oh, wow, that was heavy. I don't know. I'd say 40 to 50 pounds of honey on top in the super frames, and I got the candy on top as well. Let's put this winter bee kind back on there, because even though a lot of it has been placed on top of those frames, we're going to leave that opening toward the front there. Let's put this back on here like this so that we can leave it on top. The bees can go in and out of that opening there. Get the bees off the top like that. Okay. Well, gosh, I'm casting a long shadow behind me today. The sun is getting ready to set in about an hour. Sun's setting about 4:30 or so, but I wanted to take a minute and bring you up to date on my solar array. I'm really excited about it. It's really been working out well for us. We had this installed sometime late September, so we haven't had it that long at all. After we had it installed, it did take a while for things to be inspected, tweaked. We're still waiting on our utility company to do their inspection and then swap out my meter. I know some of you are further along in your discovery of solar panels and how it works out for you. And it's always a big question, is it worth it? And you're further along. This is all new. I'm like a kindergartner when it comes to this. What I like about it is on nice days, I can look at my app and I can actually see how my solar panel array is doing, how much energy it's making. Since I don't have a meter that actually sends any excess back, right now the solar array is just providing me what I'm demanding. So right now the property is asking for 1.70 kilowatts and it's actually providing that. And if I turn my electric heater on, it actually calls for more. It produces more or sends more. And I like to watch that app and experience that. So we're really excited about it. Looking forward to getting our meter swapped out with Ameren, our utility company. And then we're gonna spend at least a year looking at the overall usage and how much this provides, how much savings it might actually bring us. So that's gonna be exciting to watch. We haven't had it long enough to really give it a good run for its money yet and do any comparison. But I wanna keep you guys up to date and let you know the progress. Many of you have been asking, so I thought I'd let you know. But so far, man, it's really been great.